You're going to manifest behaviors and you're going to manifest sort of this confidence just basically from knowing that you have other options. And again, that comes from understanding abundance rather than living in a sense of scarcity. And you were saying before, most guys live in a state of scarcity because after a while, if you live in that for long enough and you realize that you're sort of living hand to mouth, and I mean that like figuratively, when you do that, it starts to work on your personality. It starts to work on the way that you think about things. And again, this is not a you know, get up and go kind of. I'm not a motivational speaker whatsoever, as you know, but it's just simple pragmatism. You have to have irons in the fire. You have to have other options. You will be in a much better position to decide what it is you want and the choices you want to make and the power you have over your life if you live in a state of abundance. And again, having those options is how you get to confidence. That's why guys who seem really cocky, it's not that they're arrogant so much as it is that they realize that if this doesn't work out, I've got other things going on that I can spend my time on. So it's not so much about like, you know, focusing on one thing, as you were saying before in the beginning here. It's like most guys, they think that if they lose that one girl, that it's all over for. She's the hottest girl I've ever got, or she's the first one to spread her legs for me, or whatever else. That's because you don't have any options, and you're not confident, and she picks up on your unconfidence, for lack of a better word, because you don't have those options. And what's funny is when you're in that state, if you're with that girl, and suddenly you get in shape, suddenly you win the lottery, right? In whatever way, shape, or form, right? Then you'll notice that there are behavioral manifestations in yourself that come from the knowledge that you now have this money in the bank. You now have a better body because you've been at the gym. You now have something else that's going on for you. And people pick up on that and they will react to you and deal with you in a way that is reflective of their picking up on the fact that this is a guy with options. You don't have to, a rich man doesn't have to tell you he's rich. He just simply, you, the way he looks, the way he talks, the way he acts, you can tell that guy has options. That's the difference between a confident guy and an unconfident guy.
I agree with that. And I think that's also the reason why it's so important to do the work. That same boss that wants to either not give you that raise or give you that raise, you should go in knowing that you have an upper hand in that conversation because you have acquired the skill set to be of value to him. And people directly treat you how you train them to treat you, and that value genuinely comes from what you create for yourself and you know for yourself.
You know what they,
that's why the work's so important.
You know what they say about like guys will say this all the time, is like when a woman like is monkey branching, like she doesn't, you know, let go of the other branch until she gets to the other one. Guys do that all the time too. They just like, we focus on women when it's like, oh, she's hypergamous and so she's got a better option, so she's one branch to the other branch. Make sure, if I had anything to tell guys as advice or life advice, like we were saying before, is don't be a monkey brancher. The guys who are monkey branching are the guys who don't have options. They're like, okay, I've got this branch and now I got to let go of this branch. It's one to the next. You should have 10 branches to grab onto after you let go of that other one. That's the difference between monkey branching and having those options that will provide you with confidence.